Hello student, welcome in the today's lecture. In the today's lecture, we are going to discuss the automated GCMS operation which is present in the fourth chapter, that is GCMS. In the previous lecture, we discussed the points identification and quantitation procedure, use of isotopical label standards and precision, accuracy and limit of detection. This part we have already discussed in the previous lecture. Now, in the today's lecture, we are going to discuss the automated GCMS operation, automated data acquisition, automated data analysis. These points we are going to discuss in the today's lecture. So, this is the content of the today's lecture. These are the references. The first is automated GCMS operation. In automated analysis is routine in GC. These automatic injectors, commonly called auto samplers, can be adapted to almost any model chromatograph. The most advanced instrument have a built-in software to control their automatic operation. Means how the operation is done automatically, that is explained in this slide. Instrument control is much more complex for GCMS system than for a single chromatograph. The operation of an auto sampler for GCMS analysis requires advanced software and coordinated control of four devices. The auto sampler, the chromatograph and the mass spectrometer analyzer and the data storage device. These four devices are coordinated control in the GCMS operation. Why the total GCMS automation has been slow to develop are the following points. How the developed GCMS automation? So here first point is GCMS operation for many years have required scientist level operators and analyst for data acquisition and interpretation. This often resulted in the use of GCMS for non-routing difficult samples, where the sample throughput was not expected to be a great. Interpretation of GCMS data using older data system was slow and laborious. Early GCMS work was done using packed column and interface devices such as jet separator. A great deal of skill and personal attention to each sample was required to obtain optimized result. Mass calibration on some early instrument was subject to drift and frequent recalibration. Computer technology has now advanced to the stage where a dedicated computer system for GCMS control and data analysis is both fabulous and economical. Modern computers are much faster than earlier systems. Important recent advances have been made in electronic interfacing and bulk data storage devices such as a disk drives. Then the second point is automated data acquisition. Unattended analysis of the sample has three requirements: automatic injection, repetitive mass spectrometer scanning during GC operation, and rapid data transfer to a storage device. Devices employed for automatic sample injection are commonly called autosampler. Devices employed for the automatic sample injections are called autosampler. Injection of sample is performed in much the same manner as by a human operator. Okay. The sample is introduced into GC-MS system in the same manner by injection through a self-sealing septum. Such a system is simple, effective and reproducible, but does have some disadvantages. The techniques such as hot needles and solvent plug injection containing sample air and solvent layer are not used. Although in principle they could be programmed, alignment of the needle and the injection port septum must be precise, or needle could be bent when performing an injection. Okay, it is clear. A sample is introduced into the GC-MS system in the same manner, means human operators introduce the sample just like that. The sample is introduced into the GC-MS system by injection through the self-sealing septum. Such a system, it is simple, effective and reproducible, but does have some disadvantages. That introduction has some disadvantages. This technique, when we introduce the sample, then hot needles, solvent plug injection containing sample, air and solvent layer are not used. Although in principle they could not be programmed. Alignment of the needle and injection port septum must be precise, or the needle could be bent when performing the injection. The automated system will still try to analyze all the sample for which it has been programmed, even if injection become impossible. Another important concern is cross-contamination between the sample. This is another disadvantage of that automated data acquisition. A disadvantage with most current autosampler is that they cannot perform one column injection using wall-coated column. Okay. Then automated data analysis. Last point from this chapter, a typical data analysis procedure could include the following points. How the data analysis is done, automated data analysis, they explain in the following points. Get the data file name from list, read the data file from disk, find the GC peak, then after that, perform initial functions such as background subtraction, normalization, spectrum, calculate the ratio of selected ion monitoring analysis, plot normalized spectrum and retention time. These operations are performed initially. Okay. Then compare the mass spectrum with the database of the reference spectra. Whatever the spectra is obtained by SIM analysis, we compare that spectra with the reference spectra by library search for the peak identification and include the retention time or the retention index data in identification criteria. Calculate the peak area for quantitative analysis. Quantitative peak by comparing the area with the area of internal or external standard. Repeat the step from 2 to 6 until no more peaks are found. Again, repeat the step from 1 to 7 until all the samples are analyzed. Print the final report and include all the sample identification and GC-MS analysis condition in a customized header. All the retention time, index data and compound identification and quantitation is done. In this way, the automated data analysis, it is performed by the following points. Okay. So this is about this lecture, and in this today's lecture we are completed our fourth chapter, that is GC-MS, gas chromatography and mass spectrometry is completed in the today's lecture. In the next lecture we see the application part which is remain in our syllabus. Okay, thank you.